You are with the news. I'm Seher Zama. Just in a few minutes, a couple of minutes from now, Parliament is to begin a three-hour-long debate discussion on the air pollution, on the air toxicity emergency across North India. This is going to be a dedicated three-and-a-half-hour discussion which has been planned to address various aspects of this. What's causing it? How to fix it? What works as a deterrent on ground? Congress MP Manish Tiwari, BJD MP Pinaki Mishra are among the MPs who will speak on this. At the end of this discussion, which is at the end of about 3.5 hours, we will have our Environment Minister Prakash Javarkar then respond. It is certainly going to be all eyes on the Lok Sabha in just a bit. Let's in fact go across to our correspondents. We have Alok and Ayushman with us from Ground Zero in the worst affected. This is the national capital. First to you, Ayushman. We'll be looking at how, once again, when we talk about the situation today, put that in perspective of what's going to be discussed in the Lok Sabha. We still haven't recovered. We are still headed towards a severe AQI in a couple of days' time because we can't entirely remain dependent on wind speed to fix this.
Unfortunately, that is the dependence the national capital has on the wind condition, Seher, if you talk about the situation. If the wind speed decreases in the coming days, which is expected as per the Indian Meteorological Department, the air quality will degrade. And that is what has happened. Till 14th and 15th, the situation was bad. And from 15th and 16th, the wind speed ranging to the speed of 25 to 30 kilometers were blowing. And that led to the particular matter removed from the national capital, and the situation improved. But in the coming days, we can it is expected that the air quality will dip. On the other side, an important discussion in the Lok Sabha today on the situation of air quality index in the national capital and the pollution in the northern India. The leaders are going to debate as to what the centre has done and what all steps are needed. If you remember in the last session, there was a question asked in this where the centre came ahead and gave them all the information as to what are the concrete measures that centre has taken. But today, yesterday only, if you remember, Prakash Javadekar came in an electrical vehicle. Manoj Tiwari was there in a bicycle. They came here citing that pollution in the national capital and the in northern region of India has increased. Today, a debate is to take place, after which the Minister of Environment, Prakash Javadekar, will tell what the centre has done and what centre extends to do.
That's right. And let's get in further ground inputs. This is with respect to the person on the street here, the worst affected because of the pollution crisis. Alok, you've been getting us several voices. And given the fact today, after a huge mess up of a huge number of parliamentarians having bunked a parliamentary standing committee meet, today the Lok Sabha is dedicated 3 hours. Does this instill confidence to the person on the street that yes, the government is going to be looking at more, apart from what the government has announced as measures, what have worked, what have not worked? Today, the Lok Sabha is to dedicate 3.5 hours to this.
Yes, sir, definitely there are expectations from the people. In fact, the people will expect from the government that something will happen so that they would not get such kind of pollution level in the coming days as well as in the coming years as well. In fact, I am standing in Greater Kailash area. I'd just like to show you the place where I am. So this is very heavy traffic movement, always remains very heavy, heavy traffic. In fact, I would like to show you the cleanliness that has come in the quality of air, because you can see the sky there in the you can see the sky there. The sky is little bit clearer than before. In fact, earlier it was not at all clear like this as we are seeing and as we are experiencing because of the climatic condition. As we know that when the speed of the wind increases, then the air quality definitely increases also. So the way it is happening. In fact, the people of Delhi are also thinking that whatever the measures are being taken by the government, it will be come on ground in the future, and also the wind speed will remain like increased, and then they will get the pure air. But as of now, they are all eyes on the parliament, because the discussion is going to be happen in the parliament. So let's see what will come out from the parliament. We hope that something
concrete
will come out.
In fact, while you speak to us, we're also running those live inputs coming in from the Lok Sabha. We would in fact dip into that audio as soon as the discussion regarding air pollution starts. But if I could quickly squeeze in one quick word before that discussion starts. From Mr. Anand Arya, environmentalist with us. Mr. Arya, in your view, this discussion should largely be with respect to how this needs to be fixed rather than what's causing the problem?
Well, I think, I mean, Mr. Javadekar will talk about that we have done A, B, C, D. And he will say that, okay, we have released 1,700 crores or 1,500 crores for, to the Punjab and Haryana states for not burning the parali. But I think parali is the problem created, burning of the parali is problem created by the rich farmer of Punjab and Haryana who use the combined harvester, leaving a huge stock of the paddy. They just take the grain away and the husk away. Now, and in between the two crops, there is very limited amount of space, time available for them to, treat this and let it dry and let it, rot into the field. So I think it is a problem of the rich farmers causing this. You see, when a poor farmer cuts the parali just 3 or 4 inches from the ground, and then he just harrows his field using a tractor, this all gets become a kind of a biomass and a fertilizer for his field. Now, unfortunately, Punjab, Haryana, the rich farmers are not doing this. They're just burning it, because within 10, 15 days, as soon as the end of November comes or the first week of December comes, they have to sow the wheat crop. And I think the solution, if you look at it, this is not done anywhere else in the country, because Bengal, Andhra, Orissa, tell me which state is not producing paddy. Everyone is doing. And for Punjab and Haryana, actually, it's not a natural crop, which has not been traditionally grown. It was only during the period that we were talking about a green revolution that the farmers of Punjab and Haryana were incentivized. And with enough water available from all the rivers and the canal system, that, the paddy was taken. I think it is time when we have 3 times the paddy that we need in this country, the 3 times the rice grain that we need in this country, this is time that Punjab and Haryana switched over to something else. Or they just be directed, you produce paddy, nobody is raising a question on that, but you cannot burn the parali, period. You see, and for this, an iron hand has to be used, to my mind. Because I'm seeing not only in this area, I'm seeing in every field, this thing where the law is there, the action plan is identified.
That's
the responsibility is identified, but who is delivering on the ground? Let me give you another example, ma'am, if you would just permit me.
Okay.
There are 7,57,000 wetlands in this country which are extremely critical for the water security of this country. But who has notified? Not one single wetland has been notified since 1971 when we signed the, Ramsar Convention.
We got that point. Mr. Anand Arya, we got the gist of what you're arguing here, that there needs to be an iron hand, but what is this iron hand which is going to be working in a democracy such as India? You have deterrence. In fact, I'm going to put this question forth here for further information. Our correspondent Ayushman with those details here.
Okay.
You have, so Mr. Anand Arya, you have deterrence as criminal action or hefty fines, but even that iron hand is not working.
Simple.
Yes, please go ahead.
It's very simple. Like I said, no, iron hand will work if you apply at the right place. You see, the person, the chief secretary of the state who is supposed to be governing the state, put the chief minister in the hard jail for 3 days, just for 24 hours, as in the case of a contempt of the Supreme Court orders.